changing position.
Whatever you say.
Moving to designated position. Armor of the mind. Shot wide. Target neutralized.
Well, how about that? Target.
Forgive me.
Okay, so I'll admit, it was probably a dumb idea to go by myself, but what were the chances of you guys tagging along to go look for my records? Slim to none! But you gotta think long term. I'm looking out for our future. We can't afford to lose the music of our past, can we?
X-ray neutralized. Moving to position. This is gonna hurt.
The signal in this area was already down, but the chrysalids were still coming out of the woodwork. I didn't give a damn about the DJ's records, but that didn't stop him from ignoring the fact that we were out here protecting him while he nursed his alleged back injury.
I will move.
Got it covered. I can couldn't do that.
Back online. Seems doable. Yeah, you know, I wish I could help you guys out, but the recoil from those guns would just tear up my poor back. I mean, maybe if we find an ice pack or something, I'll be able to jump back into the fight. Doesn't hurt to keep an eye out anyway.
Moving! On your order.
No problem, boss. Scanning.
Overwatch!
Moving to Overwatch.
I will sense any disturbance.
Enemy repositioning.
I said earlier, the DJ was essentially a walking target in combat. He refused to even pick up a gun, much less fight with one. The best we could hope for was that he kept his head down and his mouth shut until we reached the evac point.
Confirmed, on the move. Enemy down.
Yeah.
heading out.
I can handle that. We're green to go.
Come on. You can't really blame me for playing around with alien technology. You guys do it too. Don't think I haven't seen your toys. I'll admit I could have taken things a little slower. Maybe done some testing first, but sometimes you just gotta jump right in and pull the trigger, you know?
Hard target, minimal damage. Feel the power of the Templars.
I'm going.
To that position.
On the move. I'm on it.
Let's rock!
On Overwatch.
Come get some.
I will not waver.
DJ had shown that at least he felt some contrition for his mistakes. And his heart was probably in the right place if it had fizzing advent. I wasn't ready to let him off the hook just yet, though. We were still in the thick of his mess.
Repositioning.
Position confirmed.
Come on!
some of my earlier experiments. A green slug here, red one there, some other alien stuff. Yeah, you could say I had a few close calls. I'm guessing I won't be having kids anytime soon either, if you catch my drift. I'll tell you what, I know how to put a ham jam in a womb bone anytime.
On the move. Understood. Moving out. Together we are strong.
Eyes are peeled.
I can handle that.
Affirmative. Covering now.
There wasn't a whole lot of time to get out of there, and there was no way we could fend off this many chrysalids forever. If we didn't keep moving, there was a risk of being overrun entirely.
Still up.
Hostile target dying. Moving to position.
Seems doable.
On Overwatch.
Moving.
Orders confirmed. Moving out. Got it covered.
Watch begins.
As you command.
For the second time now, we had ushered the DJ to safety. No thanks to him. We had to get this whole thing done pretty quick. We had no idea just how bottomless the supply of chrysalids was out there.
Wouldn't you rather deal with this now than later anyway? But there could be thousands of those things in the ocean, maybe tens of thousands. If I hadn't have drawn them in, you wouldn't even know they were out there. I mean, you could almost say I helped you guys out. Really?
I'm out.
Heading home.
Let's go.
Packing it in.
Returning for reassignment.
I'm going.
We took a few hits here and there. The chrysalids don't stop until they're dead. Fortunately, we made it clear with the DJ alive and ready to steer us towards more problems. We picked through the settlement and salvaged what we could. We were slowly piecing together some decent gear, but we had to choose carefully. Recap what we've learned so far. The DJ had taken alien technology, screwed around with it, and accidentally created chrysalid lures that he then placed along the coast, which attracted hordes of these monsters from the ocean of all places. This is when I almost lost it, because this is when we found out about the DJ's boat docked outside another city further up the coast.
We are concealed.
On board was his computer. Scheduled to broadcast the latest pre-recorded installment of Pirate Radio. What choice did we have? We set off for yet another target. We barely had any time to reach the boat before that transmission was scheduled to inadvertently call in even more chrysalids to the shore. There was no way to approach near the docks, so we had to work our way through the streets, with the DJ giving us directions over the comm link.
Moving on target location.
A useful aid. As you order. As you direct.
Let's do this.
Time to motor.
Scanning.
I'm on it.
Watch order.
Eyes on the prize.
So what you're gonna want to do here is head up the main drag there. You should see a restaurant on your left. Or wait, was it a bookstore? Sporting goods, maybe, yeah. And you'll see what I'm talking about. Just up the road there.
hiding now. Shield.
People used to complain about their GPS navigation maps. Well, imagine using one of those, except directed by our DJ friend here. We might as well have been moving through the streets blind. It was that bad. I don't know what I was thinking. Like I said before, dumb ideas sinking into tired brains.
I'd get him next time.
On your order.
should be on the water before you know it. My boat should still be sitting right there, you know, where I left it, assuming no one found where I hid the keys. I just hope my computer's still there. Hey, remember, you promised not to smash it.
Take a new approach. Yes, Commander.
Back in.
Copy that.
No one gets by me.
The DJ pleaded with us not to destroy his computer along with his recordings. So we agreed that once we reached the boat, we would hack in and shut down the broadcast. I'm not exactly sure why we had to hack in. It was his computer. But I don't remember anyone asking any questions at the time.
Roger that.
To that position.
Got it. Moving.
If they move, it's on.
On Overwatch.
I will not waver. I am watching.
On Overwatch.
We hardly even know each other. I got sensitive data
on some of those drives.
I'll point you toward the files we're after. You guys can take...
And that's the planet. Forgive me. Deflection.
You see that one?
Four.
This is gonna hurt!
Wasn't all that much to it. We knew we'd have to fight, and that's what we did.
Damn, winged it.
throwing the hook. My confidence. They're repositioning on us.
I walk on the edge of life.
Time is sort of the essence here, you could say. The clock is ticking. I just hope I'm remembering the right broadcast time. Sometimes I forget and things start a little late or a little early. You should probably get there soon, just in case.
This world is ours! good. On the move.
Gremlin, medical detail. Seems doable.
Moving there.
Moving. Got it covered.
Reloading ammunition.
At this point, we were all sick to death of dealing with the damn chrysalids. I was starting to worry that even if we shut down all these transmissions, whatever undersea hellhole those things were coming from was only going to keep filling up the sea until they came ashore regardless. That was when we first spotted the DJ's precious computer.
Will do!
Got it, moving.
A long run!
Got it!
I'll keep an eye on it.
I'll maintain my watch.
The DJ's next broadcast was going out soon. Real soon. We had to hurry.
Okay. Alright, so I admit, I might have unleashed a biblical plague on the world, but I was doing my things down. I mean, we might even stop them completely. It's not too late. Look how good you're doing. Not even close.
Bypassing security. I'm in.
We stopped the broadcast, but there were still enemies in the area that we had to deal with.
Whatever you say. Scanning.
Changing position. Must reload, now! It is under my watch.
Okay!
My watch begins.
watch. Come get some! Moving to position. On your order.
Overwatch confirmed.
Moving to Overwatch.
No need to ask twice.
I am watching.
Move, move, move! The power guides me.
Got it covered. No problem, boss.
Affirmative. Moving out.
Covering now.
Covering distance.
Without much time to spare, we shut down the timed broadcast and spared the DJ's precious recordings. The DJ had a few interesting items stashed away on his boat. I'm not really sure why, though. It wasn't much for fighting. Probably used them for trading, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
had just about enough of the DJ and his secrets. I was about ready to beat it out of him, but finally he came clean. I wasn't kidding before when I said the guy was a crackpot. The true source of the all-powerful signal? An early advent chip transmitter. Somehow he got the bright idea of hooking into this thing, despite barely knowing what it actually did. His story was so ridiculous it almost made sense.
We are concealed.
None of us were scientists, and our solution was simple enough. We'd just blow up the transmitter and undo everything the DJ had put into motion. Simple. We came into the area near the waterfront. The chip transmitter was a ways off in the distance, so we didn't have a lot of time to wrap this up. Back then, there were only a few Advent city centers, and we didn't know a whole lot about their chip implants. I do remember thinking it was a strange place for a transmitter, though. And I just hope the DJ hadn't left anything else out.
Moving out.
Designated position.
Yes, Commander.
No trace.
Eyes on the prize.
Yes, Commander. Overwatch begins.
On Overwatch. Moving to Overwatch.
Not that chip transmitter, whatever you called it. Well, that was actually one of the first things I found. I'm not sure why the aliens abandoned it, but it was just sitting there, waiting for someone to come along and fire it up. I just had to make a few adjustments.
A useful aid. The choice is made.
Mine.
about that armor. Terminated. Target eliminated.
I can handle that.
I decided to leave the DJ at his post in front of the radio in case there were any other surprises left waiting for us down there. I think he had finally gotten the message, though. We weren't screwing around anymore, and none of us were laughing.
Position. Special delivery. That armor's tough.
Whatever you say.
Them.
All I ever wanted to do was bring a little joy, a little light to the dark, gloomy lives of the average fringe-dwelling human. I almost did it, too, you know? I mean, you enjoyed the show before you found out it was actually the siren song for 1,000 sea devils.
Okay. From the void.
Ammunition.
come for me!
We brought along some makeshift X4 charges to take down the transmitter, but the alien alloys were tough. I wasn't completely confident it was going to work, but I made sure not to mention that to the others. If it came down to it, I was willing to do whatever it took to put a stop to this.
Armor.
About the trouble, all right? But imagine if you guys couldn't kill aliens anymore. You just couldn't. Someone came and took away your guns, your knives, your pointy sticks. They took away your purpose, the outlet for your talent. That's how I feel when I'm off the air.
The Templars. Unstable.
Seems doable.
changing position. Readying weapon. I await their approach.
To be honest, I was focused on blowing up a piece of alien technology that might or might not end up exploding in my face. I really wasn't paying all that much attention to the radio at that point, but I'll admit, maybe I was a little harsh on the guy.
My weapon. Target neutralized.
but I actually tried to get in with one of those admin propaganda announcers. It's basically the only job they have for people who have a way with words. They didn't take me, of course. I didn't pass the psych test. But I mean, what does that have to do with being on the radio? Sure what was going to happen once we blew up the transmitter. We didn't have time to make much distance, so if anything crazy happened, we were going to get caught right in the middle of it. Even expecting the worst, we were still bound to run into a few surprises.
On the move.
Stepping off.
Advancing quickly.
Orders confirmed. Moving out. Affirmative. Covering now.
My senses are
on
keen.
Overwatch.
Maybe you guys should consider starting a little radio network of your own. Freedom Radio. Battle cry of the resistance. Something to get your people good and riled up before you head out on an alien hunt. Think about it. I could be your guy. You just tell me when. Wham! I'm there, baby.
I'm on it. Scanning.
Copy that.
A great distance.
Solid copy.
No one will slip past.
On that point, surprisingly enough, I agreed with him. After all the work we put in saving him, we might as well get something in return. Once he managed to pull it together a little bit, learned to work through official channels, he had a future in radio, and the Resistance was actually better off for it.
Will do!
I'm going.
Moving there.
Confirmed.
I'll keep a watchful eye.
I'm covering.
Moving to Overwatch.
It is under my
watch. Moving to Overwatch.
Seems doable.
Etienne Batal.
Roger that.
It was hard to miss the transmitter. The DJ had done a number on the alien components to rig it up.
I am watching.
Overwatch!
Got it covered! On Overwatch!
Attacking on sight.
Ready for me?
Ready to go.
Come get some.
Ready to rock. Overwatch
begins.
We planted the bomb. All we had to do then was sit back and enjoy the show.
Location confirmed.
Go, go, go!
I will go.
No need to ask twice.
That seems reasonable.
I will not
wait.
I move. We will fight together.
Going hard.
Grapple on. fight! Rolling out!
Definitely starting to run short on time. We had to get in there and blow this thing up before we got overrun. After all the trouble we went through, it was almost cathartic to blow up that final transmitter. We made some sacrifices along the way. Not everyone made it out in one piece. But who knows what kind of nightmare we prevented by shutting down the network before things went any further.